Hi there, I'm back from vacation and it's time to start a new project. I'll probably do a video about my vacation someday, but in this video, we're gonna start moving towards building an inventory using Bolt. At the end of this video, we'll be able to click on an item in the world and that click will be registered on the item. So without further delays, let's get into it. I already started a new project and I built out a scene using the same assets that I used in the previous project, the Kenny's Nature Kit. And what I want to do in this video is create a way to register a click on the item in the world. So as you can see, my scene has a carrot. If I click on the carrot, I want the carrot to do something. And that's exactly what we're going to make. Now, some of you guys were asking to make a tutorial of how to use Lean Touch. I did look into a Lean Touch Unity asset pack. So though you can use Lean Touch with Bolt, in my experience, it's not the simplest thing to do. And with the task that we're trying to achieve here, I think it'd be faster and easier to create it just by using Bolt. So let's get started. So first, I'll create a new flow macro and I'll name it OnTouch. And the idea is to make OnTouch a super unit. And I already showed how to create a super unit and how to use him when I was creating collision triggers. And there's another tutorial that you can watch by CodeMonkey also on super units. And I'll leave the links in description. So I'll go and edit the graph right now, go to full screen. So let's add a custom event here. We'll name the custom event isTouched. And under nesting right here, we'll add an output. And the only output that we're going to have is the control output. And we'll name it onTouch. We'll hide the label and connect that. And that's pretty much it for our super unit onTouch. It's pretty simple. But in case we ever want to modify something in this step, we can always come back here and change that without going through all the implementation. And now let's create the logic that will be triggering this isTouched event. Let's exit full screen and create a new macro and we'll call it RayHit. Let's go to full screen. Inside here, we'll add an update event and this macro is going to be responsible for finding out which item we click on in the world. So how I'm going to do that is use a ray that will be shot from the camera into the world. And whenever the ray hits the object, we'll trigger the custom event that we created. So let's go in here. And let's start creating the logic. So first we need to check if the mouse button is pressed. So mouse button, we'll check for button 0, which is going to be our left mouse button. And we'll use the Boolean output to branch out our flow. If the button is pressed, we want to create our ray and we can create it from screen point to ray. And we'll use this one right here. The screen point to ray uses a camera. For that, we'll use the main camera. So we can get main. That's going to be our main camera. And the position is where our mouse is clicked. So we'll get the mouse position. From these inputs, a ray will be created. And now we can use this ray to do a physics test and see if that ray is going to collide with anything in the world. So we can find physics, raycast. And there's a lot of options, but the one that we're looking for is this one right here, ray, hit info, and max distance. Let's connect the flow. The max distance is the distance that we will allow the ray to travel to find that hit. So if we don't want the ray to travel too far, we can limit that. I'll just set it to 100. And now we have a Boolean output, which is going to return if the ray hits something or not. And we'll branch out on that Boolean value. Connect the flow. If the ray did hit something, we'll get true. And that's when we want to trigger our custom event. So trigger custom event. And the event name that we used was isTouched. So we'll set that. But we want to trigger this custom event on the object that we collided with. And inside the hit info, we can retrieve that game object. So we can get transform. And from the transform, we can get game object and pass that in. And now the event will be triggered on the game object that we touched. We'll come back to this graph in a little bit, but for now, let's test it out. To test if it works now, let's go to our crop caret And for a ray to be able to hit the object, we need to have a collider. So we'll just add a box collider for our carrot. And now we can add the flow machine for the carrot as well. We'll use the embedded graph. Let's click add it. And inside here, we can remove that. We can just add the untouched super unit that we created. And we can do whatever we want when it's touched. So let's actually destroy game object and we'll pass in self. So we added the logic for the carrot. And now we need to add the ray hit graph somewhere. So let's create a new object and we'll just call it ray hit. Go to inspector, add a flow machine, and let's set it to be a ray hit. Now we can click play. And if we click anywhere around, nothing happens. If we click on the carrot gets destroyed. But there's still something we need to do. So let's first create a prefab from this carrot. Let's create some duplicates, move them around. So we have more than one, some like this. Click play. When I click, you can see that more than one carrot disappears. And I still have my mouse button down. Whenever I move the mouse over those carrots, they disappear as well. And it's because if you check the flow graph of our ray, whenever we press the button, the ray gets shot every single update. And that's not what I want. I just want it to be shot once per click. And it's a pretty easy fix. We can go to controls and there's a control unit called once. So whenever the button is pressed, instead of shooting a ray each frame, what we want to do is trigger it once. So we'll pass it into our once. And from the once output, we'll connect it to a camera. And to reset this once, we'll do it whenever the button is released. And that will be the false. Connecting it like that should get us what we're looking for. So now if I click play, you can see when I click the button, it gets fired once. And if I move it over, nothing happens. If I click on a specific carrot, it disappears and that solves our issue. So there we go. We were able to create the ability of clicking on the object in the world and making some action when you click on it. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we're going to start building out the inventory UI. If you have any questions, write in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.